हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर शैलेश कौशल, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ लखनऊ, लखनऊ। सो इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रा द कन्फर्मेटरी फैक्टर एनालिसिस और मेजरमेंट मॉडल। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग इट, आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस द केस स्टडी यूज इन दिस कन्फर्मेटरी फैक्टर एनालिसिस। Now you can see here, this is a theory of plant behavior, and there are five factors of this theory: attitude towards purchasing, subjective norms, perceived behavioral control, purchase intention, and purchase behavior. And each component has minimum three questions or measured variables, like attitude towards Shimla. It has four questions. And subjective norm, three questions, perceived behavior control, four questions, purchase intention, three questions, and purchase behavior, three questions. And the format of my questionnaire is like this. You can see all the questions are in a Likert scale. One means strongly disagree and seven means strongly agree. Now I want to draw this diagram, the measurement model and confirmatory factor analysis. Okay, so I'm drawing this part diagram in Amos graphic. So this is Amos graphic, but before it I want to say something about the measurement model's validity. So there are two approach to find the measurement model's validity. One is examine the goodness of fit indices, and second is evaluate the construct validity and reliability. So here we will find first goodness of fit index and then construct validity. Okay, so in whether we are performing structural testing the structural model or validity of the measurement model, in both the cases we find goodness of fit indices and construct validity and reliability. Okay, so the process is same for both. Construct validity can be find through the convergent validity, and there are three methods here. Convergent validity, one is factor loading, average variance extracted, reliability, composite reliability. Okay, so and the discriminant validity, another component of the construct and construct validity, and third is nomological validity. So how to find the convergent validity? So I told you there are three methods to find the convergent validity. One is the factor loading. This is the factor loading, and the factor loading should be greater than 0.714. Okay, so all the values of the factor loading should be greater than 0.714 theoretically. Okay, so this is also good. There is no problem. All the values are the greater than 0.714. So the question is, the first how to find the convergent validity. The one method, all the factor loadings should be greater than 0.7. so we can say all the 17 variables have the greater than 0.714 value. So there is no issue. Second is, if someone factor loading value less than 0.74, like 0.680 and something, then we find the another method, that is average variance extracted. So we square of this variable, factor loading, square of this, square of this, square of this, and then add and take the mean, means divided by the 4. So we can see here the average variance extracted, that is 61.97. so theoretically it should be greater than 50%. Okay, so 50% average variance extracted should be greater than 50%. So here it is 50% greater than 50% greater than 50%. Okay, now the in this factor matrix, this is the factor matrix of measurement model. So we can write this measurement model in this way. You can see the measurement model. This is the measurement model. This is measurement model. So here attitude, it is a factor. Now we can see here the attitude, attitude एटीट्यूड इट इज़ अ फैक्टर एंड इट हैज़ फोर फैक्टर लोडिंग्स वैल्यू. ओके सो वी कैन सी इन द ग्राफ पार्ट डायग्राम देर आर फोर वैल्यू. दिस इज द वन टू थ्री फोर सेम एज थ्री ऑल दीज आर द फैक्टर लोडिंग वैल्यू. सो वी कैन प्रेजेंट आवर डेटा इन द पार्ट डायग्राम. ओके दिस इज बेसिकली फैक्टर मैट्रिक्स एंड द सेम डेटा वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग इन ए पार्ट डायग्राम. सो दिस इज द कम्युनिटी मीन्स स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस प्लस स्क्वायर बिकॉज इन ए मेजरमेंट मॉडल वी एज्यूम the relationship of this variable highly related with this factor and zero is unrelated to this. So we will square of this, we will get the communities, and when we divide subtract from one, then it is the error variance. Okay, so this is the second method to find the convergent validity of the data. And third is construct validity. The formula of construct validity is this. Through this formula we can add all the factor loading value. This is the construct validity of the attitude. So we have five components, so we will find the construct validity all five components, like the construct validity of attitude, construct validity of the another is construct liability of subjective norm, construct liability of perceiving perceived buyer control, perceived purchase intention and purchase behavior, and all the values of the composite reliability should be greater than 0.7. So there are three methods in this. You can see the three methods of finding the convergent validity. So factor loading, if factor loading all the measured variables factor loading greater than 0.714, so we can say there is no issue of convergent validity. Another method, the average variance expected, it should be greater than 50%, and the composite reliability should be greater than 70%. So we can find the construct validity, convergent validity, either factor loading, average variance expected and reliability. But we find factor loading and average variance because we need to find the discriminant validity, because we need average variance expected and squared interconstruct correlation to find the discriminant validity. Okay, now how to find the discriminant validity? Now you can see the formula of discriminant validity. This is the formula, or we can say it's a this is the matrix of the discriminant validity. Okay, you can see there are five component: attitude, subjective norm, perceived behavior control, purchase intention and purchase behavior. So in a principal diagonal we take average variance value, average variance expected. So in the first component attitude, average variance expected was 61.97. So we are taking here in points. So 0.6197, 0.756, 0.6, 544.77, 37.67, 57 and so on. And all the interconstruct means attitude and subjective norm, the correlation between the attitude construct and subjective norm, and then we square it. So all the squared SIC means squared interconstruct correlation. All the squared interconstruct correlation should be less than average variance expected, then we can say there is no issue of discriminant validity. So here we can see all the off diagonal values are less than the principal diagonal values. Okay, so there are, and the another thing, the nominological validity, the relationship between the attitude and subjective norm, it is positive. So the relationship between the constructs should be theoretically supported. Okay, and the another method, the assessing the goodness of fit indexes. So there are five values we have find here. You can see here the first is C mean by degree of freedom. It should be less than it should be less than 2. And the other, all the three measures, goodness of fit indices, One is absolute fit index is means GFI, goodness of fit index. Incremental fit index means Tucker level index, and parsimony fit index. All the three values should be greater than 0.95 theoretically. And one badness of fit index should be less than 0.08. Okay. If we obtain the value greater than the cutoff value, it means our model is fit. Now the drawing, I am drawing the path diagram. So path diagram, this is, I am creating the path diagram. This is unobserved variable. So I have selected here the unobserved variable 1, because in this model we have 5 construct. So I am duplicating it. This is the duplicate object, and I am giving some space so that we can draw the good path diagram. And the third is here, and fourth construct here, and fifth construct here. Okay, so now the first construct has, you can from the diagram we can see first construct has four items you can see here, four items. So we will draw the four indicators here. So indicator, you can see this, and I am ticking four times, 1, 2, 3, 4. And second construct, three indicator, 1, 2, 3. And then we see the third construct, how many? Four construct. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Okay, so total 27 constructs you can see here. 27 constructs, and I am rotating all. So the rotating, how to rotate, you can see here. Sorry, undo, rotate. Okay, we can see, we can rotate like this. And then we need to draw the covariance. So there are two methods. One is manually we can draw the, sorry. One is manually we can do it, but we can use plugins also. So you can draw 10, but I'm not using it. So I'm just selecting all the five construct, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the constructs, this I am selecting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I am using plugins, and here you can see the draw covariance. Okay, now the automatically you can see here, and deselect all, and I want to move in this diagram, in this rectangle, select all, and then move. Now I can move it. So I want to show the data file. So this is my data, the data 81, 82, total 17 questions, and the 17 questions filled by the 300 respondents. Okay, 300 respondents. Now you can see the 300 respondents. Now the graph, sorry, the path diagram is this. Now I am selecting, so I am giving the name of each variables. So first of all, I will select my file. So select data file, I can go here, select data file, the file name, and then desktop, this is, okay, this is my file. So before analyzing data, we should select our file. So this is file, and then analysis properties. But before analysis properties, I will give the name of each indicators. So here you can see these are the measured variable. Measured variable, this is measured variable, है ना? And measured variable, means this is measured variable, questions basically, or we can say observed variable, and it is unobserved variable. Basically it is a factor. So like in a factor matrix, you can see the factor matrix. I am drawing the factor matrix. Variable v1, v2, v3, v4, okay, and this is the factor attitude, my first factor. So these are the factor loading value here, you can see. And at, basically it is a latent variable or factor. And v1, v2, v3, these are the measured variable, means questions. So we have to give the name of each measured variable. And so I can select here the, this is, if I am drag and drop here, the whole question will appear. Now you can see. Okay, so what should we do? So we go to the view and interface properties, and then miscellaneous. Here you can see display variable name. So I'm unticking display variable labels and apply, and then OK. Now I am transferring one by one. I am taking 81, 82, 83, 84, the subjective, norm, second, construct, exogenous. So here in a measurement model, we treat all the variable exogenous. So B, perceived behavior control, one, drag and drop, you can see easily. So it is very easy, you can do practice. You can make in within a 5 minutes. So purchase intention one, purchase intention two, purchase intention three. And the last question is purchase behavior control, and purchase behavioral control two, purchase behavioral control three. Okay, now I am giving the name in this oval shape. Okay, the I'm just copy and pasting. The name is attitude, so I can manually write and copy and paste here. And sample the font size I can adjust here. So I'm taking 12. The another variable, that is subjective norms, so copy it, and I'm just pasting here. And the variable name, and the third variable name, that is perceived behavioral control, copy and paste here. So the font size, otherwise it will outside the oval shape. So fourth construct, purchase intention, copy and paste here again. Font size 12, I'm taking 12 font size. And the purchase behavior copy, purchase behavior copy, and I can write here manually also in variable name. And the font size is 12. Okay, now so these are the error terms, E1, E2, E3, E4. Okay, so we can use plugins and draw unobserved variable. These are the unobserved variables. Okay, so I'm just ticking it. Now you can see E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, E7, E8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So my model has become, now I'm analyzing the model. How to analyze? The analysis properties and output, indirect, standardized estimates, and then calculate estimates. So there is one variable, purchase intention. It is creating the, two times we have written purchase intention here and purchase intention here. So what is the variable name? The purchase behavior. So I couldn't write here. So purchase behavior परचेज बिहेवियर. ओके नाउ इट्स ओके. नाउ आई एम परफॉर्मिंग इट, कैलकुलेट एस्टिमेट्स. नाउ माई मॉडल एस्टिमेट्स. तो सो आई एम राइटिंग ईयर रामानुजन. ओके रामानुजन सी एफ ए. सो इन दिस फोल्डर आई एम सेविंग. नाउ माई मॉडल हैज बीन रन. नाउ यू कैन सी द मॉडल हैज बीन रन. दिस इज अनस्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म एंड दिस इज स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड फॉर्म. सो दिस इज माई मॉडल. यू कैन सी द मॉडल. सो आई कैन कॉपी इट. आई कैन कॉपी द दिस एंड पेस्ट इन एनी इन ए डेस्कटॉप. आई कैन पेस्ट डेस्कटॉप. सो यू कैन सी हियर. सो डेस्कटॉप आई एम जस्ट पेस्टिंग. ओके सो वी कैन पेस्ट इट. ओके सो थैंक यू वेरी मच. नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई विल इंटरप्रेट इट.